beamlines and different kind of beamlines you have worldwide you have seen. But wherever ions are generated and whatever is their process, but the main person who detects and what it is coming from the reaction, that is the main part which comes into detectors part. So detectors are a very sensitive point where you are supposed to detect the what is produced, and you don't want to miss anything whatever produced in the reaction. So that's why you have to calculate such a sensible and such a intense and such a detective each and every component what you are produced in the reaction. So that's why this topic is detectors, one of the detector which is planned for the FAIR experiments. So Degas detectors, name is given, Degas spectroscopic gamma array spectrum. So here when we are planning for the detector, so already existing detectors, why, what are the drawbacks of the existing detectors we have to see. Then based on that we have to see what is the main requirement for the present designing of this detector. So this Degas detector, especially we have three features in this, like high purity germanium crystal and low temperature, maintained at low temperature and high vacuum. These are the three key points where we have to focus for the detecting the at high resolution. So high purity germanium crystal, it is the impurity is at the 10 to the power of 13 centimeter cube, and here low temperature, why we have to maintain, like when we have a valence band and conduction band, at the room temperature it should not conduct any transmission. So that for that we have to maintain at the low temperature. So it will be at the liquid nitrogen temperature, and these detectors are at the room at the liquid nitrogen temperature, and outside is the room temperature. So that difference how we are supposed to maintain. So for that we need a high vacuum inside this near to the crystal. So that vacuum will be the very high, up to 10 to the power of minus 7 millibar will maintain. So that the distance between your crystal and the outer surface of the detector will be hardly, it will be a 3 millimeters or 4 millimeters. In such a small gap, the difference of the temperature is so high. So just imagine we should have such a high vacuum we should maintain so that condense should not happen. So these are the key points when we are designing the detector, and this is the Degas detector where we have a crystals over here, and this is the outer box for this. The distance between these crystals and your outer part will be the 2 to 3 mm, and from here we will have some more detectors called back catchers, and these are the plastic scintillators and BGO, bismuth germanium detector crystals also we may use. Different options are available, and here we will have some electronics point, like here we have a preamplifiers where the initial signals is converted into signal whatever is generated, and here we have some high voltage maintenance also involved inside the detectors. And earlier detectors we will keep the high voltages outside for this detector, but in this detectors we are planning high voltage also inside the detector we are going to keep, so that there will be no more extra connections for single crystal, single detector. And here we will have some microcontroller where this is the first time which we are using to control the gain, the variable gain we want to try out. So different types of gain when we want, depending on the experiment we will select the gain, and that control is done from here from the microcontroller. And here we will have a sensors, like a temperature sensor inside the temperature, how much it is at the crystal level, and at the electronics point of view what is the temperature, all sensing points will be here. So this is a cooling section, and how we are going to maintain this liquid nitrogen temperature. In the earlier detectors there will be one liquid nitrogen container. So for every 12 hours or in a regular cycle, we'll pour the liquid nitrogen in the detector, And during that time, there is a possibility like there will be a damage of some electronics or some possibility of damages are more. So to avoid those things, this time we are planning with the electrical cooling. Electrical cooling we are planning here, and this is under the test right now. If it is successful, then this will be the degas detector with first time with the electrical cooling using this detector. And coming to this, just now as Sadhguru was talking about the detector array, so this is the detectors array, how it is going to be with the degas detectors, and these are the lanthanum bromides array arranged in the spectrometer. And this is the another experimental setup in the phase 2, we are going to arrange this detector. This is also one of the reason why we are going with the electrical cooling, because if we have a if we have a liquid nitrogen divar, so we can't arrange in this fashion, like we can't go side by side crystals, we are unable to arrange. So this is also one of the reason why we are going for the new detectors. So coming to challenging point in this, and different points, different parts are designed in India here in our TIFR. So these are the parts which are related to this detector. And this is the bottom deck, it is called inside this crystals will be holded. And these are the key cold finger, this is the holder for the crystals. The three crystals will be placed on this and that will go inside this. And these are called back catchers which will be used for the compound separation. And this is the place where it is located. And these are the holding stands in between. And this is the preamplifier place. As I said before, this is the controller, this is the electrical cooler. And these all parts, already it is in the exhibition. When you visit, please go through once again. And you can see all this in your hand. With your hands, you can feel like how much it is, how it is manufactured. And coming to the importance of this detector is the main resolution. Where earlier if we go for the sodium iodide and lanthanum bromide, the resolutions are not such a good compared to here. You can see lanthanum bromide and this is the this is with a clover detector, but germanium crystal is used. So there are some always when we are designing some electronics, so we have to take care further how we are going to proceed. Like when we are talking what is the gain you are going to keep, and how much is the per MeV energy, how much it should be, and what is the limitations for that. All those calculations we need to do, because further operations we are going to use the acquisition system, like where analog to digital conversion will be there, and for that there will be a analog to division, the analog to digital conversion ICs will have a limitation. So like 1 volt, if we have a limitation, then based on that we have to calculate our gain and we have to match to the acquisition system which we are going to use. So that system comparatively we are selecting the gain. So that's why we are planning the variable gain for this, so that whenever we are using the different acquisition systems, so we can modify. And coming to earlier detectors, whatever properties are there that we are comparing, and we are almost making as good as the earlier detectors, and we are modifying wherever required. Like some of the voltages for this detector is unique, like 12.5, maintaining of this kind of voltages is not universal, it is particularly separate. So where generally in the germanium detectors, like gamma ray detectors, will use this kind of plus or minus 6, plus or minus 12, plus or minus 12, 24. These we are going to use for the this detector. This is the typical structure of this preamplifier, how it looks inside. And we will have a different small cards which are like if some repairing comes, then easily we can replace it. Some of the gain parameters, and we'll arrange in one board, and one of the charge sensitive part we'll keep in another board. So this is the high voltage maintenance, whatever is there on the same board we are going to manage. These are the boards which are already we have designed and tested with the GSI. at GSI, one of the detector, one of the older detector, with that we are tested this same circuit, whatever we are planning, and that was successfully done. And this is how we are, how we start our experimental things, like small scale. First we will design some amplification and we will test it on general purpose VCB. Then if it is successful, then by parts we will test all the boards. Then if it is successful, then we will design one single board. And if this single board is successful with a crystal, with a FET, and then we will arrange this into the next detector. So just this slide shows like how this designing part goes step by step. So each stage you have to very particular about the gain and its rise time and fall time and its noise, how much it is giving, and how it is going. Because based on this only we are going to see how much gamma is coming and how we are going to define. First we will calibrate with the known sources, how much it is amplitude and all those things. Then we will check for the new gammas, whatever is coming. So that after seeing that step by step process, we will know by known source we have to calibrate. So with the cobalt source, these are the different two energies you can see here. If you observe clearly, there are two different lines you are seeing. One is for two cobalt energies. So here, this is how it looks in different stage. And this is the results when I have tested in the GSI. Last year, we have done this work and we have presented in the fair 2018. These are the results, like we got a 2.1.9 and 2.3 kV results for the cobalt. And these are the different time scale we taken, like we have tested for the 1 day and we are calculated because is there any drift or like working immediately it will show correct, but sometimes there will be some drift in the components or due to the components there will be some drift in the gain or noise will be increased if you go for 1 hour, 2 hours. All those parameters you have to take care. So that is done. And after this successful completion, we have tested with a present GSI when D-SPEC data equation system also. We have included in that and we have tested. It was done successfully. So these are presently available in the exhibition. You can see all the spare parts of this detector. Thank you. Anything if you want to like to know about the detector or?
So you got the answer of gain of this detector, right? So these are where we use these detectors in which experiment we will use?
Yeah, that's what he said, a D-SPEC experiment. It is not particular, it is designed for that experiment, but we can use anywhere this one.
So this is gamma detector?
It's a gamma detector.
In our case, we study the nucleus exadjusted. So when the nucleus produced by the fragmentation, yes, we got the realization of beam, then that beam will go hit the target, another secondary target.
Mm.
Then they will form the compound nucleus. Then compound nucleus will decay by your neutron and proton channel, and then they will emit the gamma. That gamma will detect by this detector with the coincident with the charge particle detector. And then we can say about the nucleus properties by analyzing the data.
Thank you.
Thank you. So the last part, today's quiz, same person, same question, same answer, same question.